E-mini S&Ps had a busy day on a non-farm payroll Friday, seeing a stronger than expected non-farm payroll print, pushing E-minis all the way down to the low of the session near 42.42, only to see things reverse higher as the morning went on, getting back near unchanged by about 10 o'clock Chicago time, and then extending the move higher, getting all the way up to 43.58 at one point in the afternoon. That's over a 100-point rally off the lows before settling back at 43.45. Today's 116-point range is the widest range in E-mini S&Ps over the last 6 months. And again, seeing a big rally off the lows to end higher, closing near 43.45. Now, what does this mean for volatility? Well, as you notice, volatility has been rising lately in equities as we've seen E-minis moving lower. We saw that big sharp move lower. We saw volatility shoot up to multi-month high. In fact, volatility got as high as it's been since May of earlier this year. However, on the rally that we saw today, volatility came off sharply. We actually ended the day near unchanged week over week in volatility. It was lower today, but unchanged from last Friday after the big rally in equities. Lastly, let's talk about what we have next week. Next week doesn't get any slower after a non-farm payroll Friday. We get CPI data, PPI data, as well as the minutes from the September FOMC, so we get a chance to look under the hood at what the Fed was talking about at that meeting. And then later in the week, we get bank earnings beginning, something the market is always key to watch. So inflation, minutes, and earnings all next week. So E-mini S&Ps, after a choppy trade early, trade down to 42.42, only to rally over 100 points, seeing a 116-point range out of next week's inflation, minutes, and earnings.